In this video, we're going to go over the derivatives and the integrals of the six basic trig functions. So, let's take a look at them. We'll start with derivatives because derivatives are easier. And of course, the derivative of sine is cosine. And the derivative of cosine is negative sine. And those you should have memorized down in your bones. And then the other four trig functions, if you want the derivatives of them, well, they're just ratios of sines and cosines, and so you get them by the quotient rule, and the derivative of tangent winds up being secant squared of x. The derivative of secant winds up being secant of x times tangent of x. And those come up a lot. We will find these formulas to be very, very useful. Now, the derivative of all the cofunctions just looks like the derivative of the original functions with a sine shift. If the derivative of sine is cosine, derivative of cosine is cocosine, that's sine, but with a minus sign. Derivative of cotangent looks just like the derivative of tangent, except instead of secant squared, you get cosecant squared, and you get a minus sign. The derivative of cosecant looks just like the derivative of secant, except instead of getting secant, you get cosecant. Instead of tangent, you get cotangent, and you get a minus sign. So that's it for derivatives. So now let's start figuring out integrals. The first two integrals are really easy. You know the integral of sine is negative cosine because the derivative of negative cosine is sine. And the integral of cosine is sine. So those are really easy. We'll just write them down. Integral of sine of x dx is negative cosine of x plus a constant. Integral of cosine of x dx is plus sine of x plus a constant. Okay. The first interesting case is tangent. So the way we do tangent is, when in doubt, write everything in terms of sines and cosines. And now you notice, hey, the numerator is minus the derivative of the denominator. So this wants to be done with a u substitution, where u equals cosine of x. And then du is minus sine of x dx. So this becomes the integral of minus du over u, which is the natural log of the absolute value of u minus plus a constant. So that's minus the natural log of the cosine of x plus a constant. Now you'll sometimes see this written as the natural log of the secant of x plus a constant. The reason is the secant is the reciprocal of the cosine. So the log of the secant is minus the log of the sine. So you can write it this way, you can write it that way, it's the same function. Next we've got cotangent. Well, this is the integral of cosine over sine. And now we do a u substitution where u equals sine of x. So du equals cosine of x dx. And this just gives us integral of du over u. And that is the natural log of u plus constant. So you can write that as the natural log of the sine of x plus a constant, or you could write it as minus the natural log of the cosecant of x plus a constant. All of those are equivalent. Now come the hard cases. The hard cases are secant and cosecant. So secant involves a really sneaky trick, the kind of trick that you wouldn't think of in a million years, but fortunately, somebody really clever about 350 years ago thought of the trick, and we're going to piggyback off of what he did. See, what we're going to do is we're going to multiply secant of x by 1. By 1 in a fancy way. We're going to multiply by secant of x plus tangent of x divided by secant of x plus tangent of x. I think we can all agree that that's 1. And that becomes the integral of secant squared of x plus secant of x tangent of x. divided by secant of x plus tangent of x. And now remember our table. The derivative of secant is secant times tangent. The derivative of tangent is secant squared. So the derivative of the denominator is the numerator. The derivative of the secant is secant times tangent. The derivative of tangent is secant squared. So this is the integral of du over u, where u is secant plus tangent. And that just gives us the natural log of the secant of x plus the tangent of x, absolute value, plus a constant. Now, for the cosecant, it's the same process. We write this as the integral of cosecant of x times cosecant of x plus cotangent of x divided by cosecant of x plus cotangent of x. And that winds up being minus the natural log of cosecant of x plus cotangent of x. Plus constant, of course, because the derivative of cosecant is minus cosecant cotangent. The derivative of cotangent is minus cosecant squared. Okay, so let's summarize. We've got that the derivative of sine is cosine, and the integral of sine is minus cosine plus a constant. The derivative of cosine is minus sine. The integral of the cosine is sine. Watch out for these minuses. You'll find amazingly many mistakes where people say the integral of sine is cosine instead of minus cosine, or the derivative of cosine is sine instead of minus sine. Careful about the pluses and minuses. The derivative of tangent is secant squared. The integral of tangent is log minus log cosine plus a constant. The derivative of cotangent is minus cosecant squared. Its integral is log sine of x plus a constant. Derivative of secant is secant times tangent. Integral of secant is the log of secant plus tangent plus a constant. Derivative of cosecant is minus cosecant of x, cotangent of x, and the integral is minus natural log of cosecant of x plus cotangent of x. For all of these formulas, for the cofunctions, if you know what it is for sine, tangent, and secant, you automatically can figure out what it is for cosine, cotangent, and cosecant. It's the same formulas, only with the cofunctions and with a minus sign. It works for derivatives, it works for integrals as well.